Good evening and welcome back to the 54th International Vocal Competition Lied Duo in 's-Hertogenbosch. My name is Anna Trombetta and I have the privilege of being your host for tonight's concert. The week thus far has been filled with recitals from our esteemed jury, as well as, of course, the performances in the semifinals from our duos. Last night, the finalists were announced, and those four duos were rehearsing all day today in preparation for the finals taking place at the Verkade Fabriek here in 's-Hertogenbosch tomorrow at 4 o'clock. The entire event will be streamed online on the IVC YouTube channel so that you don't miss a second of the competition. Those duos that unfortunately did not advance did have the opportunity, however, to take part in master classes today given by Dame Sarah Connolly and Charles Spencer. In just a moment, to round out a day of absolutely gorgeous music, tenor Christophe Prégardien and pianist Roger Vignoles will perform Robert Schumann's Liederkreis here from the Staatssaal in het Noord-Brabant Museum. Afterwards, for those at home, there will be an interview that I had the pleasure of holding with Christophe Prégardien earlier this week. We are ready here in the hall, and I'm sure you are as well, to hear this legendary musicians perform tonight. So without further ado, performing Robert Schumann's Liederkreis here in the Staatssaal, tenor Christophe Prégardien and pianist Roger Vignoles.
Good afternoon, good evening. After Anna said hi to our many viewers online, I welcome you as the director of DVC. I'm Ivan van Kalmthout. I won't make long. I'm just really happy to see you here. Hope to see you tomorrow all at 4 o'clock at the Verkade Fabriek for the finals. And also, just to let you know, because of the corona measurements, people who have been here already know it, there is no drinks in the break. If you really need to step out a moment, you can do, and we kindly ask everybody else to just stay in the seats. Thanks for your cooperation, and now it's time for great music. Thank you.
Wunderselig hab ich Es weiß und trägt es doch keiner, wie mir so wohl. Ach, wüsste es nur einer, kein Mensch es sonst wissen soll. So still ist's nicht draußen im Schnee, so stumm und verschwiegen sind die Sterne nicht in der Höhe, als meine Gedanken sind. Ich wünscht, ich wär ein Vöglein und züge übers Meer, wohl übers Meer und weiter, bis dass ich im Himmel wär. Es weiß und rät es doch keiner, wie mir so wohl ist, so wohl. Ach, wüsst es nur einer, kein Mensch es sonst wissen soll.
Thank you.
Sterne mit glühendem Liebesblick. Es riecht eingeschlafen auf der Lauer oben ist der alte Ritter drüber in Regenschauer und der Wald rauscht durch das Gitter ein gewachsener Bart und Haare und versteinert Brust und Krause sitzt er viele hundert Jahre oben in der stillen Klause. Draußen ist es still und friedlich, alle sind ins Tal gezogen, Waldesvögel einsam singen. Eine Hochzeit fährt da unten auf dem Rhein im Sonnenscheine. Musikanten spielen munter und die schöne Braut. Ich höre die Bächlein rauschen im Walde her und hin, im Walde in dem Rauschen. Ich weiß nicht, wo ich bin. Die Nachtigallen schlagen hier in der Einsamkeit, als wollten sie was sagen. Als sähe ich unter mir das Schloss im Tale liegen und ist doch so weit von hier, als müsste in dem Garten voll Rosen weiß und rot meine Liebste auf mich warten und ist doch so lange tot und ist doch lange tot. Ich kann wohl manchmal singen, als ob ich fröhlich sei. Doch heimlich träumt dieses Grauen bedeuten? Hast ein Riedel lieb vor anderen, lass es nicht alleine grasen. Jäger ziehen im Wald und blasen, Stimmen hin und wieder Hüte dich, sei wach und munter. Es zog eine Hochzeit in den Berg entlang. Unten fängt's schon an zu blühen.
Good evening, everyone. As the festival continues on, I have the chance to talk to renowned tenor and jury member of this year's 54th International Vocal Competition here in Sertogenbosch, Christophe Prégardien. Christophe, thank you so much for joining me. It is an honor to be able to talk with you. Tell me, what does it mean for you to be on the panel this year at the competition? What does that do with you?
Hello, and thank you as well from my side. So it's my first time, as you say, at the vocal competition here in Sertogenbosch, and I'm very happy and proud to be here, and especially because it's a vocal competition for lead duos, and as you know, I love singing leader, and I love being in the panel of a jury for lead competitions, and it's always an amazing encounter of young talents, and it's so it's just a pleasure to listen to all of them, or nearly all of them.
So what does a lead duo mean to you? Of course, you have your own experience with it. Why is that a special thing about this competition?
The special thing is, in comparison to a normal competition, a normal vocal competition, that the collaboration between the pianist and the singer has to be very intense. And we as a jury are we should listen not to the singer and not to the pianist, but to both of them as a unit, mm-hmm. as a artistic and musical unit. And you can easily hear whether they have much experience together or whether they have not. And what I would love to hear in a young duo is also that normally, if you look at a recital, very often the singer is the center of the whole thing. Mm-hmm. But what I love is to have a real partnership between the piano and the singer in terms of artistic leadership. Yeah, very mm-hmm. often the pianists are a little bit shy, and mm-hmm. now we have a lot of pianists coming up which are full of self-confidence, and I like that very much.
Do you find it rare to see a duo that has that you know, perfect balance, or is that something you see a little bit more often? How do you?
I think it's changing. Time is changing. In former times, also if you listen to recordings, the piano was somehow behind the singer. The singer was in the foreground and the piano in the background. And artistically spoken, it's the time after the Second World War, so coming up with people like Fischer-Dieskau, with people like Hermann Prey and Christa Ludwig, that they had their fixed partners, they had firm partners for the collaboration. So let's talk about Hartmut Höll with Dietrich Fischer-Dieskau, with Helmut Deutsch and Hermann Prey, mm-hmm. and where the equilibrium between the both personalities was equal. And now we have many duos, from my point of view, who are able to show this kind of collaboration on an equal balance.
Yeah, fascinating. It's really fascinating to hear you talk about it. So as many people at home may or may not know, your son is also a tenor, and you both perform together, literally passing the torch through generations. Do you see something in your son, maybe, or in the participants that gets you excited about the future of the lead genre?
Yes, there are several things, but I think the main thing is that the new generation of singers is much more open-minded to a certain kind of expressivity, a certain kind of emotional showing what is happening in their selves as personalities, not on an artificial kind, but in a real felt, in that moment felt, intensity. And that's what I ask also my students, and what I love with Julian, for example, is that he is so intense in that moment where he performs a song. And if you listen to several recitals, you can see big differences depending on the mood, depending on the audience, depending on the surrounding you're mm-hmm. making music. And so I'm sure, and I'm full of hope, I'm not sure, but I'm full of hope that these young duos which are coming up now also draw attention from a bigger audience in future, because as everybody knows, Lied has some problems with getting audiences, but audiences is not the problem from my point of view. The problem is the presenters who say, oh no, Lied is difficult to understand, and it is difficult to understand because it's high artistry, and you have to prepare yourself as a listener by reading the texts. You can't go there like in a symphonic concert and just enjoy the music. You have to prepare yourself for song, and I hope that we find our audience in future as well.
I hope we do too. It's such an amazing, rich genre that it should be shared with as many people, and I think it's a shame to, you know, allow it to fall through the cracks, as it were. So do you have any last words of wisdom for the participants of the IVC?
Last words of wisdom? No, I think what I said before, we have to struggle for this art song, because it's so rich, and so many generations of composers and poets have given their efforts to this kind of art. And of course we know that classical music in the whole is something not for everybody. So many people compare it to pop songs or to pop music or to rock music. We shouldn't do that. We can't expect so many people's attention to classical music. But we have to be self-confident and say we are doing something very seriously and very very sincere and art, and we have so many younger and older musicians who love this art song. And so I will go on struggling all the time, and you will as well, as I know.
Yes. Well, I call those words of wisdom. I don't know about you. Live coverage of the 54th International Vocal Competition will continue through November 21st, when the judges will determine the winning duo. Check out all of our interviews with the judges and duos, as well as former laureates, right here on the YouTube channel. See you soon.
Bye-bye.